Dominik Durna dla MMORock, ze mną jest Yasuo Enomoto przed walką ze Slambekiem Saidowym na KSW 34. Hello, how you doing here in Poland? How are you spending your time now?
Right now I was signing a lot of posters, that was the thing.
It's a hard work, right? It's
very hard work, no.
It's even sometimes harder than the fight.
I don't think so, but...
Okay.
Nope. Today we were walking around a little bit in the super mall, but nothing special, only check my weight and... Looking forward to eat tomorrow. That's the main target at the moment.
So how is your weight?
It's good. It's about 80 kilos now. But I'm feeling really drained and tired. So it will be difficult tomorrow. Even if it doesn't sound like a lot of weight. But I was cutting already very, very lot of weight.
Okay, you are going to fight with Aslanbek Saidov. He's one of the biggest Polish stars. Do you knew before this fight, before this was the contract with the KSW, do you knew this fighter?
Yeah, of course, because I follow promotions and obviously I work also as an agent, so I'm taking care about the opponents, you know. So, of course, I knew he had a big name because he has, I don't know how many fights, I think 12 or 13 in KSW, so people know him over here. And he was, I think he was the first champion, right?
Yeah, in the...
So he was the first champion, I think the only champion besides the one now. So, of course, he has a good name and good reputation and... Looking forward to fight him.
So what can you say him about him as a fighter, about his skills?
His skill sets are really good, otherwise he would not have been the champion here. You know, really good wrestler with a very aggressive submission style. His striking was also getting recently a little bit better because I watched his last fight and he won by TKO, so he has also okay hands, but I think his main weapons are wrestling and submissions on the ground.
Okay, so how did you prepare to this fight with Aslanbek?
Always the same. I would say the only thing I changed a little bit is his southpaw. Mm-hmm. So I changed a little bit the combinations, but other than that, I train everything the same. You know, for me, this is one of the only things who depends, you know, left southpaw or orthodox, because the rest of the training is the same. I train hard and I try to train smart.
Yeah, you fought with the all over the world with some really great names. So, do you think that it's gonna be one of the hardest fights in your career?
You never know. You know, I had fights against people I was not expecting a hard fight, and then it came out to be, like super hard. For example, my last fight, I was thinking, okay, I know this guy already, and it was one of my hardest fights I ever had, mentally, you know, and also physical. And I was not expecting this, so you never know. You know, he will for sure be one of a very, one of the very good ones, record-wise. But the fight, you never know, can be finished very fast, or he can go over the rounds. Who knows?
Okay, your name is in the mix of the best European fighters since very long time. So why did you choose KSW? Do you have any kind of different offers from the, for example, M1 and these kind of organizations?
I was already under contract with M1, so. The thing for me was like I was not fighting here, and I think it's one of the biggest promotions in Europe, and I have names I didn't fight so far, so they could, they could offer me some good names I could fight, so that's why the decision came, plus also to get a new fan base. Mm-hmm. Because recently I fought a lot in Russia, and I think I have my fan base now in Russia, so let's try to go to another place as well.
Okay, you said that Aslanbek was a champion. Do you think that after win, with possible win with Aslanbek, you should use your next to fight with the champion, with Boris Mankowski? And the second question, is your contract only for this one fight or for more fights with KSW?
No, I have a four-fight contract with them. And if I win, yeah, of course I want to fight the champion, because in my opinion Aslanbek is number two or number one when it comes about the contenders. Mm-hmm. So why not? Would make sense, I think. And I think it would be also interesting matchup to fight him.
Okay, you said that something about the Aslanbek style. You also have a really solid base in every kind of, if any aspect of MMA, but besides that you have really really not usually seeing. You have your style is not what you usually we can see in the normal fighters. Do you think that it's gonna be hard to Aslanbek to be prepared for your style?
I don't know. Let's see. The thing is always, obviously, it's always which style compares good to the other style. And I don't know because I never fought him. He don't know because he never fought me, so I can't tell. Of course, it's how you say, it's our style. It's me and my brother's style in a Moto Do. So it will be difficult for him for sure. But like I said, it's about the person at the end of the day. You know, some people match really good with each other and some don't. You know, so. Let's see, you know, we will see on Saturday.
And what we should expect on Saturday?
I think fireworks, because like you said, do I want to fight after this fight against a champion? Of course I want. So what do I have to do? I have to make a lot of fireworks on Saturday, be very impressive, that people think like I deserve to fight for the title if I win. So I will give my best to, how we say, let the people in Poland know my name.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.